The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. We read together from Psalm 119. Blessed are those whose way is pure, who walk in the law of the Lord. Blessed are those who keep his testimonies and seek him with their whole heart. Those who do no wickedness but walk in his ways. You, O Lord, have charged that we should diligently keep your commandments. Oh, that my ways were made so direct that I might keep your statutes. Then should I not be put to shame because I have regard for all your commandments. I will thank you with an unfeigned heart when I have learned your righteous judgments. I will keep your statutes, O forsake me not utterly. How shall young people cleanse their way to keep themselves according to your word? With my whole heart I have sought you, O let me not go astray from your commandments. Your words have I hidden in my heart, that I should not sin against you. Blessed are you, O Lord, O teach me your statutes. With my lips I have been telling all the judgments of your lips. I have taken greater delight in the way of your testimonies than in all manner of riches. I will meditate on your commandments and contemplate your ways. My delight shall be in your statutes, and I will not forget your word. O do good to your servant that I may live, and so shall I keep your word. Open my eyes that I may see the wonders of your law. I am a stranger upon the earth. Hide not your commandments from me. My soul is consumed at all times with fervent longing for your judgments. You have rebuked the arrogant and cursed those who strayed from your commandments. Turn from me shame and rebuke, for I have kept your testimonies. Rulers also sit and speak against me, but your servant meditates on your statutes. For your testimonies are my delight, they are my faithful counselors. My soul cleaves to dust, O give me life according to your word. I have acknowledged my ways, and you have answered me, O teach me your statutes. Make me understand the way of your commandments, and so shall I meditate on the wonders of your works. My soul melts away in tears of sorrow. Raise me up according to your word. Take from me the way of falsehood. Be gracious to me through your word. I have chosen the way of truth, and your judgments have I laid before me. I hold fast to your testimonies. O Lord, let me not be put to shame. I will run the way of your commandments when you have set my heart at liberty. Faithful God, let your word be the treasure of our hearts, that we may delight in your truth and walk in the glorious liberty of your Son, Jesus Christ. Your word have I hidden in my heart, that I might not sin against you. It's important to know and to receive God's word, so that we instinctively know what is right and we instinctively act according to God's commandments. Your word have I hidden in my heart, that I might not sin against you. We continue in the book of Job. One of Job's comforters has just been speaking to him, and Job's comforter has suggested that bad things don't happen to good people, but God brings bad things upon bad people as a punishment. Job chapter 9. Then Job answered, "Indeed, I know that this is so, but how can a mortal be just before God? If one wished to contend with him, one could not answer him once in a thousand. He is wise in heart and mighty in strength. Who has resisted him and succeeded? He removes mountains, and they do not know it, when he overturns them in his anger. Who shakes the earth out of its place, and its pillars tremble? Who commands the sun, and it does not rise? Who seals up the stars? Who alone stretched out the heavens and trampled the waves of the sea? Who made the bear and Orion, the Pleiades and the chambers of the southern kingdoms. Who does great things beyond understanding, and marvellous things without number? Look, he passes me by me, and I do not see him. He moves on, and I do not perceive him. He snatches away. Who can stop him? Who will say to him, what are you doing? God will not turn back his anger. The helpers of Rahab bowed beneath him. How then can I answer him, choosing my words with him? Though I am innocent, I cannot answer him. I must appeal for mercy to my accuser. If I summoned him and he answered me, I do not believe that he would listen to my voice. He crushes me with a tempest and multiplies my wounds without cause. He will not let me get my breath, but fills me with bitterness. If it is a contest of strength, he is the strong one. If it is a matter of justice, who can summon him? Though I am innocent, my own lips would condemn me. Though I am blameless, he would prove me perverse. I am blameless. I do not know myself. I loathe my life. It is all one, therefore I say, he destroys both the blameless and the wicked. When disaster brings sudden death, he mocks at the calamity of the innocent. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covers his eyes, so its judges. If it is not he, who then is it? My days are swifter than a runner. They flee away, they see no good. They go like skiffs of reed, like an eagle swooping on the prey. If I say I will forget my complaint, I will put off my sad countenance and be of good cheer. I become afraid of all my suffering, for I know you will not hold me innocent. I shall be condemned. Why then do I labour in vain? If I wash myself with soap and cleanse my hands with lye, yet you plunge me into filth, and my own clothes abhor me. For he is not immortal as I am, that I might answer him, that we should come to trial together. There is no umpire between us who might lay his hand on both of us. If he would take his rod away from me and not let dread of him terrify me, then I would speak without fear of him, for I know I am not what I thought to be. Job says no one's innocent before God, but it doesn't really matter because calamity happens to good people too. Job's answer was, bad things do happen to good people. And the Lord, if he's in control, he's bringing it on me. What is going on here? Job is confused. He knows that he's been blameless. He knows that he's sought, done his best to walk right before God. He knows he hasn't been perfect, so he has no answer. But he's still asking the question. Why do bad things happen to good people? We'll continue through with Job and his comforters tomorrow. Romans chapter 5, verses 1 to 11. Therefore, since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to his grace in which we stand. And we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but also we boast in our suffering, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, and hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person, someone might actually dare to die. But God proves his love for us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Much more, surely then, now that we have been justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath of God? For if, while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, how much more surely, having been reconciled, will we be saved by his life? But more than that, we even boast in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. God didn't wait until we were ready. God didn't wait until we got our act together. But while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. While we were still sinners, he called us to himself. Father, we thank you for today and we dedicate it to you. We pray that all of our actions, all of our words, all of our thoughts will be glorifying to you. We pray for Samson and for Mike Thomas in their journeys in Nigeria. Lord, we pray for them in their travelling today. We pray for mercies on the road. We pray, Lord, you will protect them in the journey, that, Lord, they may arrive safely at their destination. Almighty and everlasting God, you have given us, your servants, grace by the confession of a true faith to acknowledge the glory of the eternal Trinity and in the power of divine majesty to worship the unity. Keep us steadfast in this faith, that we may evermore be defended from all adversaries, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.